Hi guys, I'm Kasia. Welcome to the channel and welcome as always to our coffee times. Today I am here to talk to you about everything that I read in the month of January. And actually when January ended, I was concerned that I had not read much. I had this impression that I had not read much, but in the end I ended up reading 11 things. So I am actually quite surprised and happy about it.
It's coffee time.
So as always, we rate the books in this channel with coffee mugs. We start with the lowest rating and end up with the highest rating. And there might be some surprises and some disappointments in this list. Before we go to that, if you love horror and if you love books, please consider subscribing to the channel and also hit the notification bell before you leave. With two coffee mugs, and I'm not really surprised about it, we have Supernaturally by Kristen Wiig. So you guys know I want to finish this trilogy because I started it, and I'm a completionist. Sometimes I just want to finish things, finish the circle, and since I own the trilogy, I push myself to finish it. So book two takes off after the events of the first book, and we follow Evie as she wants to live the most normal life as possible. So in these books, in this trilogy, we have this world in which there are supernatural creatures that are being controlled by this paranormal institute. And my problem with the story is that, you know, it reads way too childish, even for being a YA. I read YA, and this one particularly really reads really childish for my taste. There was something in this book though that made me nearly DNF it, and that is when I started smelling a love triangle, and I was like, there's a lot that I can take, but I don't know if we can add a love triangle to it. And also things are getting a lot more predictable, a lot more repetitive. There is like no thrill in the story at all. And something else that I don't like, but that is just a personal taste, is that every time the main character has to curse, they just write bleep, and I just cannot take that. I just can't. The next book was one of my disappointments, big disappointments, and with 2.5 coffee mugs we have The Bank by Bentley Little. I was extremely excited about this release in 2020 because the plot of this book reminded me of one of my favorite Stephen King books, Needful Things. And unfortunately, I struggled so much with this book. I don't even know how I managed to finish it because it was too long and too boring. We are in a small town and they start to tell you all the different problems that people in town have, you know, kind of like their personal affairs, their personal struggles, and how they all need the help of a bank, a loan, something like that. And then all of a sudden, mysteriously, the next day, there is this new bank on the main street that happened to just appear overnight, and people are being granted loans without having to prove anything. And as always, you know, when these things happen, it's always too good to be true. So with this premise, I was expecting to, you know, to have a book with more horror, with more violence, and I kept waiting for something like interesting to happen, and it just didn't. It was very basic for me and I got bored really fast. I was expecting to hear more about this bank, the reasons why this bank was there, why they were doing what they were doing, but things were developing way too slow. I think the book was just too long and it just didn't caught me. And I was so disappointed, but yeah, I just didn't love it. Next, with three coffee mugs, we have a basic thriller, and that is The Girl in the Woods by Greg Olsen. When I started this book, it actually sounded really promising to me because I was really getting to know the main characters, I was engaged with the story, and one positive thing about this book is that it is easily written, fast-paced, like I really could fly through the book, and that made it somewhat enjoyable. We are following a forensic anthropologist and a detective that work together in order to solve crimes. So one of these crimes is basically that a foot has been found in the middle of the woods, and they don't know who this foot belongs to or if it was you know, an attack from an animal or if somebody killed this person whose foot was found. And There is another case of a rich husband that dies, and they don't know if it was natural death or if it was something that also points to a crime. So they're kind of like a different type of crimes that are being explored in the book, and I was really getting into the story. But then we got to the mid part of the book and it took a turn, and it just started to be repetitive, it started to be boring, and honestly, you can see the twist coming from the very first chapters. I already called it. And that was also very disappointing for me. Also, many things did not really add up when it comes to the investigation. And basically, these two women that are doing the investigation, one of them is a forensic anthropologist, she's not even, you know, allowed to go and, you know, do interviews and investigate. She's not a detective, but she plays a detective in this book. I don't know. It was just all too convenient, if you know what I mean, and access to everything. And I don't know, I just felt like I needed more explanation for a lot of things, and when it comes to the plot twist, nobody was surprised. Nobody, not even my cats. Next, and with 3.5 coffee mugs, we have Bloodline by Jess Laurie. I do have a full spoiler-free review and a vlog reading this that I will link for you guys. So this was a very interesting thriller based on true events. We follow a journalist who is pregnant and decides to move with her fiance to his hometown, Lilydale, because she feels this is the best place to raise a child away from the dangers of the city. However, when she gets to Lilydale, she starts to realize that the people in this place are just too nice to everybody, too pleasing, and something seems to be really off. And it will give you vibes like Rosemary's Baby or The Stepford Wives. So if you like tales like that, I would recommend you to pick it up. I really enjoyed it because I like thrillers that are a little bit different, and this one definitely is. Plus, you know, the combination of the true crime, like based on true crime story. So I enjoyed it. So if you're looking for a thriller that is a little bit different and not your typical detective story like the one before, then pick this one up. Then a novella that also got 3.5 coffee mugs from me is Night of the Mannequins by Stephen Graham Jones. I really enjoyed how this book was written with a perfect combination between horror and comedy. So the balance was perfect in this book, which is something that not everybody achieves. And it is a very fast-paced read, really entertaining. There's not too much I can tell you about it because it is a novella, so it's fairly short and I don't want to spoil it for anybody. But let's say that we have a group of teenagers that are trying to use a mannequin that they called Manny to make a prank on one of their friends, and the prank backfires, the prank goes really wrong, and now they all have to fear for their lives. Now let's move to the 4 coffee mug rating. So here we have, first of all, Mr. Penumbra's 24-hour bookstore by Robin Sloan, and this is a book that, I'm just gonna put it out there, it's not gonna be loved by everybody. This book was a bit denser to read, it was very slow paced, and it is, I believe, for people that love history about books, where books come from, where, you know, writing and the alphabet comes from, like solving ancient mysteries, ancient cults, things like that. I think if you love to read about that and you don't need a book that it is really fast paced, then this might be for you. I just think this book is really unique and different, and that is why it might not appeal for every reader. We follow the story of Clay that is desperately looking for a job, and he finds this 24-hour bookstore and decides to apply for a job, and he takes the night shift. When he starts working there, he realizes that actually not many people are buying books in that bookstore. And there is some sort of like a secret section where they have really old looking books that he's not allowed to read. And strange people come to lend these books, like just to take them and bring them back. But they also don't pay for that. So he starts to wonder, how is this bookstore even still working, and why are these people coming to get those old books? And he starts investigating and of course gets caught up in the middle of something bigger. But I really enjoyed this. I think, like I said, it's not gonna be for everybody because it's very slow paced, but it was very unique and I really enjoyed the story. It gets action-packed towards the end. And I don't know, I really enjoy the characters and the group that they form that they to solve the mysteries. I really enjoyed it. The next one also with 4 coffee mugs is Frozen Charlotte by Alex Bell. And I'm really glad I picked this one up because I think this is a really well done YA story about creepy dolls. I really love the writing, I love the character development, and you basically get what you bargain for. Like, some books advertise certain topics and then they're not really explored that much, but this one is gonna give you that creepy doll story that you want. So we have here Sophie. She has to go spend some time with her uncle and her cousins that she has not seen in years. So when she gets there, she's having a little bit of trouble adapting again because she hasn't seen them in such a long time. And strange things, accidents, things start to happen in the house. And apparently this house where they live used to be a school for girls that had to close down after also a lot of, you know, catastrophes happened there. And apart from that, we have the frozen dolls, the frozen Charlottes that also appear in the story. This is perfect for people that are not ready for adult horror but would love a story about creepy dolls, because I thought this was a great YA story, and I'm definitely gonna pick up the next book that is actually a prequel. So yeah, I definitely want to pick that one up as well. The next two books are both middle grade and both got 4.5 coffee mugs from me. The first one is Your Perfect Halloween Spooky Story. Absolutely loved it, and I just cannot wait for book two, and that is The Haunting of Evelyn Jones by Phil Hikes. So I picked this one up because I heard people talking about it and saying how good it was. And as you know, guys, I want to read more spooky middle grade, and this one was just perfect. It is based in October around the Halloween season, and we follow Evelyn and she goes to spend some time with her aunt. It's funny how in horror stories a lot of kids are being sent to their relatives and then stuff goes down. We have to talk about that, we have to discuss this. So anyways, she goes there and she finds the life in this island in winter very boring because all the tourists are gone and there seems like there's nothing to do. But one day she discovers the secondhand bookstore and she goes in because she is fascinated about the topic of ghosts. So she decides to pick a couple of books about ghosts from this secondhand bookstore, and that leads her to a diary from a girl that used to live in the island but disappeared. This was such a great ghost story. I love the character so much, and I also love how this book was edited with pages in between from the diary and everything. It was just perfection. And the other middle grade that I absolutely loved was Nevermore by Jessica Townsend. So I finally read this book, which I wanted to read for some time, and this is the perfect start to a middle grade fantasy story, but also with some spooky elements added to it. And I love how the book was written, I love how versatile it is, how many different things we get to experience here, and I really love the character of Morrigan. This is a girl that all her life she has been told that she's cursed and that she's gonna die because she's cursed, but the night where she's supposed to disappear, then somebody comes and takes her to this place called Nevermore, where her real adventure begins. I absolutely love the array of colorful characters that we got in this book. There's not much more that I want to tell you about it so that I don't spoil anything, but there are also some trials involved in this book, and I'm a sucker for trials in books, if you didn't know. And also, I loved one of the secondary characters called Cadence. Loved her so much. I think she's one of my favorite characters. I'm really glad that I picked this one up, and if you are missing some middle grade wonderful fantasy in your life, this is the way. There is another book with 4.5 coffee mugs, and that is Brainchild by Andrew Neiderman. This is a book that it is very, very heavily character based, and it is a book that starts very slow, but the payoff is fantastic. I personally love this story because I am obsessed with stories about creepy children, children that are too smart, and this is kind of if Sheldon would be a psychopath kind of story, if you know what I mean. It is following Lois, and she is a girl that she's too smart for her age, and she loves science and doing science experiments, not just with animals, but at some point she thinks to herself, what if I try to also manipulate humans? And it kind of explores all of this, and there's not too much I can tell you without spoiling it. If you love stories, like I said, about creepy children, I think you will really enjoy this one. The character development is on point. You can completely see her transition throughout the book, and I love the way the book was written. It was so smart. It has also a lot of science stuff in the book that I absolutely love to read about. I was just super invested. I loved it so much. So if you're looking for this type of story, please pick this one up. And funny enough, a book that I added last minute that I decided just to read during my first live stream here on YouTube, and also a book that I recently received, got the five coffee mug rating, and that is True Crime by Samantha Kolesnik. And this book was kindly sent to me by Leslie from The Nerdy Narrative. Love her to death, check her out. And this book was, let me tell you guys, this was so disturbing and so messed up. So please be aware before going into this book that any kind of trigger warning that you can imagine for a true crime story is in this book. All of it, okay? All of it is really intense, really creepy, and really disturbing and messed up. And there is a lot of things that happen in this book that I cannot tell you because it's gonna spoil it for you, but it is really gory and it really pushes the boundaries, and I think for some people it's gonna be a little bit too much. All right, so that being said, and you guys being warned, so we are following two siblings, Susie and Lim, and they are tired of their lives and their abusive mother, so they decide to basically break free and they start a killing spree. That's all I can tell you without spoiling anything, but I will tell you the story is basically told from the perspective of Susie and how she sees things, how obsessed she is with true crime. She reads this magazine that's called True Crime, and she's completely obsessed about it, about those stories, about the killers. And this book, it was so short. It was a short novella, under 200 pages. But it managed to give you such a good understanding of who Susie is and how her mind works. And I absolutely loved it. It was really intense and I just could not stop reading. I had to take breaks in my live stream, but it is a book that I would have completely binged in like an hour because I loved it so much. So if you're a fan of true crime stories, this is a must read for you. I absolutely loved it, and I am gonna buy anything else that the author puts out there because I love the way that the story was written. It was just so intense, and the author is writing in a way that when you less expect it, then you get a slap on the face and something happens that you're like, what the F? And I loved it. All right, you guys, so these are all the things that I have read in the month of January. Let me know down below what is the best book that you read in the month of January. Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. Please give the video a big thumbs up for support before you leave. And I hope to see you all guys in the next coffee time. Bye.